Willkommen zum aktuellen Goldinvest-Interview. Sonora Metals ist ein sehr spannender Explorer, dessen Projekte in Mexiko liegen. Und zwar in sehr guter Nachbarschaft. Zahlreiche größere Unternehmen betreiben Minen in der Umgebung. Zuletzt meldete Sonora Bohrergebnisse von einem ersten Bohrprogramm auf dem Cerro Caliche Projekt natürlich. Und wir wollen uns mal genauer erklären, was diese Ergebnisse bedeuten und wie es jetzt weitergehen soll. Ken, welcome.
Thank you, Bjorn. Pleasure talking to you today.
Ken, as this is the first interview we're doing for our audience, could you please just shortly introduce yourself and give us a short summary of the background, of your background in mining?
Thank you, Bjorn. I'd certainly be happy to do so. My name is Kenneth MacLeod. I'm the president and CEO of Sonora Metals Corp. We're developing gold and silver projects in Mexico. And my own background, it goes back to the 1980s in resource development. I was involved in oil and gas development over the years, then moved into mining, geothermal energy, and back into mining. So I have a fair degree of knowledge in raising capital for junior mining companies, exploration and development projects in various parts of the world. And my colleague, John Darche, who is now the chairman of Sonora Metals as well, is also extremely knowledgeable in the raising of capital, the managing of public companies, and also in developing projects in various parts of the world as well.
Well, it's certainly good to know that you have such a breadth of expertise, especially in capital raising, because the markets aren't very favorable for juniors at the moment. So let's talk about Sonora. You have a couple of projects. We're going to focus on, as I said, on Cerro Caliche today. You just completed first phase of a 10,000 meter drill program there. We're going to talk about that in a while. Please just give us some sort of general introduction to the property. Why did you pick this property in particular?
Well, the development of this project has been in the works for many, many years. And as you know, in Mexico, mining projects are very difficult to acquire because the concessions are held by various parties, and it's extremely hard to be able to gather a block of concessions into a meaningful size so that it can be developed. However, my colleague, Mel Herdrick, our Vice President of Exploration in Mexico, knew about the project from 20, 25 years ago and was unable at that time to step in and acquire the projects until recently, until January of 2018. We met with another colleague in Hermosillo, Mexico, who had acquired approximately 9 or 10 concessions and amassed them into one project called the Cerro Caliche project. And we were able to secure an agreement with this gentleman. And following that, of course, we were able to negotiate with other concession holders in the surrounding area. And eventually, we were able to acquire a grand total of 1,400 hectares from 5 concession holders. And then we started the exploration of Cerro Caliche.
Okay. And, well, you must have seen something in the property to start going about it, or your colleague must have seen something. Tell me just shortly, who's in the neighborhood? Are there other companies active there?
Yes, absolutely. There are 3 companies very close to us that are operating or in the final stages of developing gold resources. The most prominent one would be the recent acquisition by Agnico Eagle of the Santa Gertrudis project, about 16 kilometers to our north. And Agnico is in the process of continuing to drill the project. And hopefully in the next year or two, we may see a production decision there. To our east is the underground Mercedes mine operated by Premier Gold. And my understanding is recently they've expanded the resource at the Mercedes mine as well, which is good news. And to our west is the Cerro Prieto mine, which is adjacent to the Cerro Caliche project and is in operation under the company Gold Group. And then in the less immediate area, but within 50 kilometers, we have 4 or 5 other gold mines that are operating open pit and are being very successful as well.
Okay, so you seem to be in the right spot. which also was indicated by the results you recently published, just the last batch of the first phase of the drilling. Can you summarize for us shortly what you achieved there?
Yes, we were very pleased with the results of the drilling, which commenced in late September 2018, and the first phase was completed just before Christmas 2018. We drilled a grand total of 4,600 meters and 45 drill holes. So obviously the average is in the order of about 100 meters, which suggests that the resource we are looking for is at a very, very shallow depth. Starts at surface and is very, very shallow. Now, some holes have been drilled to depth and have indicated mineralization at depth as well. But we're focusing on the first 75 meters in the majority of our drill holes. Now, having drilled the 45 drill holes, we have been successful in hitting gold mineralization on every single one of these holes. And it's in no small part a measure of the success of earlier drilling that have been done in 2007 and 2011 by prior operators. Now, these operators had drilled a grand total of 161 holes. My apology. These operators had drilled a grand total of 117 holes and have provided over 4,000 surface samples. Now, we've added to the mix with a grand total of over 2,000 surface samples. So collectively, in our database now, we have approximately 161 drill holes, totaling 17,000 meters of drilling, and over 6,000 surface samples taken on the property. So we have a very, very good understanding of the resource as it stands at this point in time. The gold mineralization we've identified covers an area of 2.2 kilometers by 1.2 kilometers. So if you take that in total of 2.5 square kilometers of area, and the concession itself is 14 square kilometers, then we have a lot of mineralization left to explore within the property. And that exploration will be conducted in areas which have been previously identified by the earlier operators as being mineralized and potential targets. And also, the sampling that we have been conducting over the past 6 months has indicated that there are very, very positive targets in the northern part of the property, the eastern part, and the southern part of the property. So we'll be following all of these areas of known mineralization, and the current drill program will continue and develop, hopefully develop a resource within those zones as well.
Okay. So a lot of work still to do, but also a lot of potential still there. Now, what will be the next steps be? You'll be finishing this drill program, this 10,000 meter drill program, and then?
Yeah, before we even complete this drill program, we'll be conducting our first National Instrument 43-101 report, and that'll be based on the first 4,600 meters, which is, of course, backed up by the earlier drilling as well. So after that, we will do an internal resource calculation, but that will give us the impetus to launch the second phase of the drilling program and complete the second phase of the drilling program, at which time we would be prepared to produce a preliminary economic assessment of the project. And this second phase of the program is expected to be completed by May of 2019. So by the summer of 2019, we should be looking at hopefully producing a resource report that will demonstrate the validity of the project and the commercial potential for the project as well.
Now, that certainly sounds very interesting. People are always looking forward to getting numbers in front of them to see what's really happening. But can you tell us a bit about... this is not a high-grade operation. The whole area is not high-grade operations. It's more about volume. Can you tell us about that? And also, how do you plan to produce it? Do you need to do... what's the method? Heap leaching?
That's a very good point. The operation, as it stands right now, is geared towards demonstrating a large tonnage, low-grade. And by low-grade, I mean it'll be... we're postulating in the order of 0.5 to 0.6 grams per ton. Which in this part of Mexico is not unusual. There are many, many mines in northern Mexico that are operating at that grade and lower grades, all the way down to 0.15 grams per ton. So we fully expect that if we demonstrate this large tonnage, that we will be able to deliver a project that can be commercially produced. As it stands right now, the focus is on developing a minimum of 1 million ounces from this particular property. We feel very confident that the initial indications from the drilling program are suggesting that we are heading in the right direction, support our theory that the project is capable of a large tonnage and low-grade deposit. It is open pittable from the preliminary testing we have done, heap leachable. And by open pittable, I mean down to 75 meters is fairly consistent with that theory. As far as the project, the geology is concerned, we are in oxides. So heap leach operation is very viable.
So a lot of potential, as we said, but also a lot of work to do. And that costs money. Do we have the funds to complete all the work you've planned for 2019?
The company is currently funded to recommence the drilling program. But as we go further down with the drilling program and as the drilling program size increases, we will be looking for additional capital. There are several ways of raising that capital, potentially with strategic partners. We also have a royalty on the Cipriona project we sold to Agnico Eagle, and hopefully that royalty will be providing some capital in the not-too-distant future. And also, we have the ability to raise capital through funds out of Asia that have expressed an interest in the project as well. And we would hope that over the coming months, we'll be able to demonstrate financing in the order of $1 to $2 million to sustain us through the next phase of the drilling program.
Okay, thank you. So we talked about Cerro Caliche, but that's not the only project in your portfolio, as I mentioned before. Can you just give us shortly an idea of what you're working on, too?
We have a project that is 100% owned by Sonoro called the San Marcial Project, located 30 kilometers southeast or southwest of the Cerro Caliche project. San Marcial is also located 20 kilometers east of Alio Gold's San Francisco mine in a similar kind of geological structure. And we have identified a mineralized zone or several mineralized zones over a 5 kilometer stretch off concession and possibly as much as 2 kilometers wide. All the surface sampling we have done has indicated good grades in the order of 0.8 to 1 gram per ton. And so we feel very, very optimistic that when we start drilling San Marcial, that we could end up with another large resource of similar size or even greater than the Cerro Caliche project. So the goal in 2019 is to finalize some other acquisitions in the general vicinity of San Marcial, and then we commence the drilling program. So that'll be for 2019 and 2020.
Okay. Certainly sounds interesting. We'll be following you over the year, and we'll certainly talk to you again and hear how things are progressing. To sum up now, why should investors have a look at Sonoro at this point in time? Why should they look at the company now? Where is the value proposition?
Well, the value proposition is, first of all, the company does not have a lot of shares issued and outstanding. We have a grand total of 31 million shares, of which the insiders control around 35%. So as you can see, the insiders are very, very committed to the success of the project. In fact, some of the insiders have been with the company since it went public in 2011, and they continue to remain optimistic and be very supportive of the company. With the new management that we've incorporated over the past year, are as enthused and as knowledgeable as anyone in raising capital in order to continue the drilling program into 2020. So we are very, very confident that the current project has been taken to a point where internally we're satisfied that we have met our goals of demonstrating a gold mineralized zone possibly capable of yielding a resource over the coming months. And so we feel very confident as we keep on drilling the project that over time, we will achieve our target goal of possibly 1 million ounces from this project, at which time one could look at it from the point of view of either going into production or a potential target of takeover by a major mining company.
Okay, thank you very much. So you've got your work cut out for this year and the next. We wish you best of luck and we'll check in at a later time to see how it went. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Bjorn. Pleasure talking to you.